discuss the learning packets, may I call on once again Mr. Rodel Rafon to introduce our second speaker. Wait lang, ayipin nyo na lang dyan, Ladley.
And have units in Master of Arts and Innovation, major in Physical Education at Bigawayan College. A former college instructor at Lady of Lourdes Hospital and Colleges of Caymega and La Salle Araneta University. One of the contributors for Learning Packets for Grade 9 MAPE, former BNHS Faculty Club President, Currently, this is manager by a group of performing arts, writer, revisiting of curriculum in music arts, physical education, health, or MAPE, crafting of learning materials, daily lesson lab, and periodic examination. Faculty member of Bignay National High School from 2011 to present. I am glad to introduce to you our colleague, Mr. Harold and Sanchez.
Sir Harold.
Thank you so much, Sir Rodel Rafon, for the introduction. May I remind everyone to please pin my camera or screen to your screen po for you to see the whole presentation of mine. And paki-close na lang po yung presentation, Mr. Moderator, para po makita nila ako sa kanilang screen. Nakikita na po ba ako't naririnig, Mr. Moderator?
Yes po.
Loud and clear po ba't nakikita po ako sa screen?
Yes po.
Okay,
yes po.
Thank you so much po. Okay, so maraming salamat po doon sa 74 participants na nag-participate in answering my pre-assessment, no? So for us to see our participants if they are already knowledgeable enough in doing instructional or creating or crafting instructional design. And so with the different contents of our learning packets. And most of the question here that got me frequently is about the major components of instructional design. But don't worry, and later we will going to tackle all those questions. No, bibigyan natin ng sagot lahat yan. No? And that pre-assessment is part of the creating or crafting our own instructional design or instructional materials, and we all know that as a teacher. Okay, let me start with this this is a survey question. So for those who have their cell phone, you can scan the QR code that reflect on your screen, or just simply go to menti.com for those who are using their laptops. Go to menti.com or scan the QR code. So mapupunta kayo sa ganitong interface kapag tinate nyo yun. Ayan, pakitype lang po kung okay na po para mabasa ni moderator kung lahat po ay nakapasok na. So you just enter or type the code 490502 and just click submit para makapunta po kayo sa first survey question. So dito po kayo mapupunta. So ang aking nakikita sa interface ay dalawa pa lamang po.
Sir, pakiulit po ulit yung
code. Okay, nandiyan dyan po sa aking screen ang code, which is 490502. Hinighlight ko po. Ito po. 490502. Again, go to menti.com. Ayan, meron na po tayong nakapasok na 11 na participants. So, our survey question. We have 13. Again, ito po yung QR code and the site. Again, menti.com. Or just simply scan the QR code for you to go or to have this kind of interface on your browser or monitor. Again, just scan the QR code or type menti.com and enter the code 490502. Ayan, may mga nagsagot. Okay, may
participants, auto-rotate lamang po ang inyong mga cellphone para makita nyo ng buo si Sir Dilip.
Thank you, Sir Moderator. Opo, for those who are using mobile devices or smartphones, pwede po nating i-landscape ang ating cellphone para mas makita natin ng buo yung aking screen. Again, pakipin po ang aking screen para makita nyo yung pinepresent ko. Again, we have 42 respondents. So the first question is, have you ever assigned to be a contributor in creating or crafting learning materials? So, ang sumagot po ng yes ay 29 respondents, and for our no answer is 19 respondents. May papasok pa po ba? Ayan, tumataas pa. So, ilan po tayo, Sir Moderator, sa ating room?
114.
Okay, 114. So, 58 pa lang po ang nakakapasok. Kahit at least maka 3/4 man tayo para at least meron tayong majority of the votes or of the survey. So we have 59 respondents. Meron pa po bang papasok? So majority of the answer is yes. So nakagawa na sila or nakapag-craft na sila ng learning materials, which is 36 respondents out of those 24 respondents na hindi pa nakakagawa. Okay. Next survey question. Have you ever applied instructional design in the learning experiences and instructional materials of your learners? Ayan, tingnan natin. Meron na tayong 6 na respondents na sumagot. Ito, 12. 21 na nasumasagot. 29. 'Yari may premyo tayo. Hindi, mamaya magpapa-prize po ako, magbabato ako ng question later, and you will going to have a surprise coming from Ma'am Maricel, which is our one of the officer of the day. Si Ma'am Maricel po ang magbibigay ng premyo. Inisponsoran niya po ang aking pag-game. Okay, we already have 54 respondents. 57. Meron pa po ba? Going once, going twice, parang bidding, no? 57 respondents, meron pa po ba? Okay, so most of the answers here is yes, which is 41 respondents. So they already applied instructional design in their instructional materials and to their learners. So very good po, no? Mas mapapadali ang ating buhay mamaya sa discussion natin later. So 12 or 13 respondents says no, and 6 respondents says I don't know, or maybe they don't know na na-apply na pala nila to, no? They are not just aware. So thank you so much po sa mga active participants na sumagot ng ating survey questions. No, so ibalik na po tayo dito sa ating slide. So those things or survey questions are related to our discussions for today. No, so because we are going to discuss the instructional design, their components, and their process as we go along on the discussion, and yung kailangan natin ma-achieve as we end this talk. The second objective that we have here is we are going to identify and be familiar with the different learning packets content na kung saan ito ay i-distribute ng division office or ng ating school, no, na nasabi na rin nung Monday ni Sir Moscosa on the implementation on the opening of classes. So ano nga ba yung mga parts or content ng ating learning packet? So mamaya papasadahan natin siya. And of course, bago mag-end tong talk natin, you are going to create a sample of instructional design. So, meron ng reading groupings mamaya. So, yung technical na lang natin ang mag-a-assist sa inyo, which is si Ma'am Lani later. So, yun yung dapat nating ma-achieve as we end our discussion on this topic. Okay, let's start with the question, what is instructional design? So nakalagay dito, most of the participants already, or majority, no? Of the participants have already an idea what is an instructional design. So sir moderator, can you ask someone who can answer this question? So ang una pong makasagot ay may puntos, and at the end of the discussion or this topic, kung sino yung pinakamaraming puntos na sagot, siya po ang magkakamit ng surprise na premyo sa ating technical na si Ma'am Maricel Reyes. Anyone po, okay, from our participants? You can comment down your answer on our chat box.
Antayin na lang po natin yung kanilang mga sagot.
For a minute, no? Para at least kahit isa lang, no? Sa ating 111 participants.
So once again, the question is,
what is instructional design? Kasi on our survey, no? A while ago, most of them already
answered. Okay, sir, may sagot na po dito. May nag-feed na. According kay Ma'am Jonna Junio of English Department, the flow of learning instruction that the school or the department will be using with your learners.
Okay.
Sabi naman po ni Sir Emerson Mora, it is like a lesson plan with topics and activities.
Okay. Those two answers got a point, no? This is a process for instructional materials or activities or experiences
na
for our students to learn or learners to learn. Meron pa po ba?
Yes. Kay Sir Pete of Senior High School, instructional design is the systematic development of instructional specification using learning and instructional theory to ensure the quality of instruction.
Correct,
napakalala. Yes po.
Meron pa po ba?
Yes, medyo madami-dami.
Ayan,
okay. According kay Ma'am Eloy of Senior High School, instructional design is the systematic development. Ah, ito din yun.
Okay.
It's a systematic development of instructional specification using learning instructional theory to ensure the quality instruction. It is the entire process of analysis of learning needs and goals and the development of a delivery system to boost.
Okay, thank you so much, Mr. Moderator. So sa Ma'am Technical, Ma'am Maricel, ikaw na po bahala magpuntos, no? So first three answers na makapasok, yun po yung lagyan natin ng puntos, Ma'am Maricel. Thank you so much. Okay, so may mga punto, tama, systematic, learning experiences, instructions, those are part of creating or doing the what we call instructional design. So if I will going to define instructional design, this is a creation of instructional experiences which makes the acquisition of knowledge and skills more efficient, effective, and appealing. So in short, these are the experiences that the learners will go through in order for them to acquire new knowledge and skills more efficient, effective, and appealing. So kung kanina sinabi ng ating first speaker, efficiency for us as a teacher. Ngayon, efficiency and effectivity ng learning instruction for our learners to learn or to acquire new knowledge and skills. And that is the what we call instructional design. Sabihin niyo lang po kung mabilis ako kasi pag medyo tension ako, napapabilis ako ng salita, no? So, in instructional design, we do have three components. So, we have tool or tools, people, and so with the organization. So, under tools that we are going to focus later, we have the process, the theory, and physical. So under in the instructional design process, these are some known processes that instructional designer goes through in creating an instruction, and one of that model or process is the ADDIE model. Na kung saan ADDIE model is also known as a systematic design of instruction. So in short, this is a process, phases, or steps that instructional activities or designs will go through in order for that instructional design to be successful and be more effective and efficient. So yun po yung ating tinatawag na instructional design process. And magpo-focus tayo dyan later, no? And we will going to tackle the ADDIE model. The second one is the instructional theory. So as a teacher, alam natin tong instructional theory na to. Dito tayo nagbabase on how our instructional materials or the learning experiences that we're going to give to our learners be more efficient and effective. So anyone po ang unang makapagbigay ng some learning theory or principles na ina-apply natin sa pagtuturo or sa pagbibigay ng instruction sa mga bata? Anyone ang unang makasagot? Magbigay lang po ng isang halimbawa ng instructional theory or learning theory or principles that we have na madalas nating ginagamit, lalo na ngayon.
Hi, Sir Joselito Jacinto.
Oh.
Instructivism. Kay yeah. Sir Mora naman po. Ay, parehas lang din sila.
Okay, constructivism.
Sir LD. Progressivism, sabi din ni Sir LD. Si Sir Peralta, learning by discovery.
Yeah.
Sir Aldo Pantre, reinforcement theory by Skinner.
Yeah,
naglas sa labas. Yeah. So we have also Sir Mora, humanism, Ma'am Raimundo, pragmatism, Sir Pete, social learning theory, and Ma'am Jaba, we have behaviorism, yeah. And again, again, essentialism. Ayan.
Thank you so much po for those participants who actively participated on this question, no? Or Q&A portion. So first three ulit, Ma'am Maricel, ha? To accumulate the highest point, siya po yung magkakamit ng pa-premium nyo. So, yun po. That's right. Yung mga sinabi nyo, mga principles and theory of learning, ina-apply natin yan for us, our learning process or instructional materials or teaching process be more efficient and effective. So, hindi ko na palalawigin yung efficiency because our previous speaker already discussed what is efficiency contextually. No? And then for the last tool that we have here is the physical or the physical tools. These are maybe an e-learning, no? Pen and paper, it should be, or the different e-learning developmental tools such as different softwares, applications, and devices like laptops, smartphones that we can use for us to give the instructional design or the instructional experiences to our students effectively and efficiently. No, lagi kong sinasabi ang efficient and effective kasi yun dapat ang maging turnout or kalabasan ng ating instructional design. Kasi nga, it will not be successful at the end of the process kung ang magpe-fail tayo sa learning process or ma-acquire na knowledge ng ating students. Okay. And then the second component or major component that we have is the people, no? So in some way nagiging komplikado yung paggawa ng instructional designer in constructing instructional design because of the people na nakakahulubilo nila sa paggawa ng instructional design. And one of that is the management. Okay? Sa management kasi syempre ito yung mga tao, no? Yung superior natin na kung saan sila yung sinusunod natin in crafting or creating our own instructional design. We need to follow. Like for example, ano ba ang binabaan ng Department of Education for us para sa gagawin nating mga panturo or learning materials that we are going to have? And of course, we need to follow the curriculum. We need to follow what is given on the higher ups or the what we call the management. Okay? The second one is the ID teams or instructional design team. So hindi lang naman ikaw or mag-isa ang gagawa ng instructions or instructional design. Marami kang kasama dyan. i-discuss yan mamaya ng ating susunod na speaker, which is si Ma'am Floor, which is one of the topic niya is the ADMLR standard, na kung saan ito yung mga panuntunan or standard kung paano gumawa ng instructional material or modules. So may mga specifications tayo dito. And we also have different people na makakatrabaho. Like for example, the writer, the layout artist, the editor, and so on. So yun yung magiging part ng ating instructional design teams. And the third one is the SMEs. Ano yung SMEs? These are the subject matter experts. So pag sinabi natin subject matter experts as an instructional designer, ikaw ay magpo-consult doon sa subject matter expert for you to improve more your content or your instructional material or instructional design. Kasi siya ang may mas alam. Siya ang may mas well-known doon sa subject matter per se. Like for example, in ICT, in music, in arts, in science, in mathematics. So we have to collaborate with this SMEs or subject matter experts. And of course, the last one in the people is the learners. So as a teacher or as a instructional designer, you have to determine or identify who are your learners. What are their needs? Ano ba yung pangangailangan nila? Paano ba sila matututo? Anong klaseng pamamaraan or strategies ba ang dapat nating gawin para sila ay matuto? Depende sa kanilang kakayahan o kapasidad. And that is for the learners. Mabilis po ba? Medyo nati-attention si Sir. No? And let's now proceed to the third component, which is organization. So sa organization po, it includes the government, corporation, military, and of course, the education setting or the education sector. So, hindi lang naman sa paaralan or sa education sector makikita ang instructional design. Again, ang iba't ibang instruction ay dumidepende sa kung anong klaseng organisasyon meron tayo. Iba ang instruction sa gobyerno, iba ang instruction sa company or sa korporasyon, at maging sa militar. So, it depends upon the organization that we have. We are going to construct or give our instruction or instructional design. Okay, may question po ba? If you have question, pa-jot down lang po sa comment box. And
so,
later,
part naman, sir,
ang Q&A portion after the first part. So, i-jot down niya ni Ma'am Maricel para ma-entertain natin mamaya at magtuloy-tuloy ang ating discussion. Thank you po. Okay, sabi ko magpo-focus tayo dito sa tools. So, these tools is divided into two types, which is the abstract tools and the physical tools. So, under abstract tools that we mentioned a while ago, these are instructional theory and instructional design process. So, like what I said a while ago, when we say instructional theory, ito yung mga theories and principles na pinag-aralan, pinilter, at in-improve as the years goes by, decades goes by, no, for us to create an effective and efficient learning instruction. And that is the what we call instructional theory or learning theories. And then the second one that we have is the instructional design process. So when we're creating instruction, it is important to have key steps and phases. And these are both abstract concepts, and also it is something that they're thinking about the entire time and they're working with other people to create instruction. So like what I said a while ago, we have different processes and models we follow to create an instructional design, and one of these is the ADI process. And for the physical tools, we have the LMS or the Learning Management System, Multimedia Development, and the Pen and Paper. So LMS includes the DepEd portals, if you're familiar on that, in the DepEd Commons, so they can access those references and also modules, and so with the different textbooks na maaari natin gamitin to develop a particular instructional design. And then Multimedia Development Tool, as I mentioned a while ago, these are softwares, applications, and technological devices that will help improve our instructional design. Okay, when we combine these two types of tools, which is the tools and technologies, we will formulate and come up with what we call modules or instructional materials. At ito yung gagamitin natin for us to assess, no, or to give learning experiences to acquire students or learners new knowledge and so with the skills. So iyan yung gagamitin natin. So paano nga ba natin malalaman na successful ang isang instructional design? So we need to have this kind of process, which is the ADDIE process, which stands for analysis, design, development, implementation, and evaluation. So these are the five phases that the ADDIE process have. And ADDIE process is one of the generic and widely accepted model or process in terms of creating or doing an instructional design. Kaya dito tayo mag-focus. Actually, marami siya. May some model tayong tinatawag na kung saan simplified ng ADDIE model. But I will going to show you the generic one, which is yung widely used na process na ginagamit. Okay, let's start with the analysis phase. Okay. So in analysis phase, we need to identify who are our, or rather, we need to identify what's the problem, okay? That will provide a solution at the end of constructing of our instructional design. Ano ba yung problema that we need to have a solution right now? Well, for example, season of our or school year, ano ba yung nakikita or na-identify natin na problem na kailangan magkaroon ng solusyon? Sige nga po, anyone who can comment on our chat box? Sir Moderator, pabasa na lang po na magsasagot. Anyone who can identify? Ayan, si Sir Pete, sabi niya
connectivity. First is connectivity. Ma'am, Jan Sarihido, internet connection. Ano, integrity of assessment. Ayan. Ma'am Narita Cortez, the pandemic itself. Elinita Villegas of Senior High School, same. Sir Jacinto, reading improvement in a pandemic setting. Ma'am Jan Sanjago, availability of materials. Ma'am Aileen Pagatpatan, comprehension of the students. Ma'am Leia Tabirara, identification of appropriate delivery mode. Sir Emerson Mora, the modules.
Okay, thank you so much po sa mga nagsagot. Ang ganda nung yung kay Ma'am Jed, no? Ano yung sabi ni Ma'am Jed na one of the problem?
Integrity of assessment.
Yan. So, integrity of assessment, since we are doing distance learning or modular approach. Aside from that, yung class size na sinabi ni Ma'am Pagatpatan, no? So, there are so many problems that we need to provide solution. Ano yung mga pwede nating mabigay na remediation for that? And aside from that, sabi ni Sir Pete, internet connection or internet connectivity. So we need to provide a solution on that particular problem as we go along on these phases. So we are already identified the problem, and also we have to identify what are the learning goals. Okay, identifying what are the learning goals. So learning goals is very huge or malawak. And once you create or form a learning goals, on the next phase, i-discuss natin kung paano natin siya ma-extract. And aside from the analysis phase, we also need to identify who are our learners. Okay, sabi ko nga kanina, dapat alam natin kung anong klaseng estudyante meron tayo or magkakaroon tayo. Sabi nga natin kanina dun sa internet connectivity, having a gadgets or smartphones. So, alamin natin yung capability and capacity ng ating learners. Hindi lang yung capability and capacity on that particular aspects, and also yung kakayahan niya para matuto. So sa ganitong klaseng modality ba, makaka-cope up siya. So that's why we are formulating the what we call learning packets or content of learning packets na i-discuss natin later. And the last one on the analysis phase is to identify the time frame. So time frame of the entire development process for the student to learn that specific instruction. So, yun yung time frame natin. And that is for the analysis phase. So, if you were going to sum it up in this phase para itong planning, no? Pagpaplano na kung ano yung mga dapat nating kailanganin o gawin as we go along on the process. That is the analysis phase. The second one is the design phase. Ang hirap pronounce ng phase. Okay, design phase. First is, the learning goals are already transformed into learning objectives. So yung mga learning goals na in-identify natin doon sa first phase, which is analysis phase, will be transformed into learning objectives. So magiging specific na tayo. Kasi mahirap gawin or mag-come up sa isang successful instructional design kung malawak yung aspeto na panggagalingan ng proseso mo. No? So that's why we have to form our learning goals into learning objectives. And then under the design phase, this is also the time that we are sketching storyboards and wireframes, and so the writing of scripts, no, on doing or creating our instructional materials. So pag sinabi natin instructional materials, hindi lang naman to pagsusulat or paggagawa ng module, maaring instructional video, maaring form of assessment or different form of activities, like for example enrichment activities, worksheets. So those are part of the instructional design process or needed, no, to have a successful instructional material. Okay, so paggawa na, pagbuo na. And then the third one is the development phase, wherein the content is already created. No, nandi dito na. At kumbaga, we are already furnishing and completing the things that we have done on the previous phase, which is the design phase. Na kung saan ipa-finalize na natin, i-improve na natin for recording, editing, or proofreading, no, ng ating instructional materials. So, kumbaga, ito yung pagtatapos or pagbubuo na ng ating instructional design or instructional activities or materials. And then, for the fourth part or phase or steps in instructional design, we have the implementation, wherein the instructional materials or activities created or furnished is already given or distributed to our learners, na kung saan dito magtatakda kung ano ang magiging resulta ng ating ginawang instructional design or instructional materials. So that is the implementation phase. And then for the last part is the evaluation phase. Dito natin malalaman how successful our instructional design is. No? We are going to gather the different data collected on the implementation phase. So malalaman natin yan kung ito ay successful or not based on the result of the data that we gathered on the implementation phase. So kung ito ay medyo bigo, so we need to revise the content. So we need to go back, like for example, we need to go back and on designing. So ano ba yung problema so in this phase? So for us to improve more. And so with the development phase, or maybe there is a problem on implementing the instructional material. No? So we need to go back on those process. So in short, it is a cycle, no? We need to go back hanggat hindi natin na-achieve successfully to have our an efficient or effective instructional design or instructional material. Okay, may question po tayo doon. So, the process is widely used by instructional designers, and it is a useful process, no? When creating almost any part of curriculum, big or small. So classroom-based man yan, school-based man yan, division man yan, or regional, ginagamit ang ADDIE process, maliit man o malaki. And to sum it up, again, ADDIE process is stands for analysis, design, development, implementation, and of course, evaluation. Again, once you failed on the evaluation or the result of the data collected is not that good result, you can go back to the previous part or phase of the ADDIE process. Is there any question po? You can comment your question on our comment box. If we have question, I'll give you 1 minute for you to answer, to drop down your question. Kung wala, magpo-proceed na po tayo sa ating susunod na discussion, which is the content of the what we call the learning packets.
Okay, let us check first kung may pumasok sa ating chat box. So far, wala.
Okay, let's just wait no for a minute. No, malay mo, nagta-type, mahaba yung tanong. I would like to grab this opportunity habang nagta-type sila ng question to thank Sir Richard Moscosa for having me here as one of the speaker. Salamat sa tiwala. Ewan ko kung ito ay tiwala o parusa. Maraming salamat, Sir Richard, sa pagtitiwala no, na magbigay sa akin or maibahagi itong kaalaman na to na ginawa natin on our previous webinar. And also, I would like to thank our school head, Sir Valera, and our assistant principal too, Sir Alan Roque, and to our assistant to the principal, Ma'am Jed Camposano, maraming salamat po sa oportunidad at sa tiwala no, para makapagsalita sa ating webinar or ating in-service training. May tanong, mukhang wala naman po. Thank you so much po at walang nagtanong. We will now proceed on the next part of this discussion, which is the learning packet content. So ito yung i-distribute natin or ipapamasyag.
May tanong.
May tanong
yes, po.
Sir LD.
Sir LD, may tanong daw.
Ah, okay. Ito, kapapasok lang po. So, question number one, what is the most advisable instructional materials that we can use for our students? And question number two, can we consider feedbacking as an evaluation?
Okay, sa instructional material po, or if you're referring to strategies or tool, maaari po kasi depende yan sa kung anong sitwasyon meron tayo. At depende rin sa kapasidad or capability ng ating mag-aaral. Like for example, we do have different learning modalities and we do have different learning tools in using or giving learning experiences to our students. Halimbawa, we have Messenger versus Google Classroom. Eh, ang estudyante mo walang kapasidad para makapag-connect sa internet. Meron lang siya smartphone, pero wala siyang pambili ng data or load. So, pwede tayong mag-go doon sa Messenger kasi yun yung generic or mas afford ng ating bata. So we can use that as one tool for us to deliver our instructional material to our learners. Again, magbabari po siya as we discussed a while ago, magbabari siya sa klase ng ating mag-aaral. Okay? So in our analysis space, we need to identify who are our learners. Okay? So kasi walang tama, walang magaling na instructional materials. Again, ang instructional materials natin ay magbabase sa kung anong klaseng mag-aaral meron tayo. Nasagot po ba ang tanong, sir?
That is question number one. So, yung question number two.
Number two.
As a question.
Ayan, dumadami na. Akala ko walang tanong. Second question, sir. Ano yon?
Can we consider feedbacking as an evaluation? Nasagot na po ba?
Pwede naman po. Depende nga po sa approach or strategies na gagamitin natin. Again, sabi ko nga, instructional design, kayo ang mag-co-construct or gagawa ng inyong approach and strategies. Kaya nga meron tayong tinatawag na different learning theories and identifying our learners para mas maging effective ang ating gagawing instructional material or instructional design.
Question po mula kay Sir Peralta of Senior High School. What are the guiding principles in the first phase, which is analysis?
Principles, nasabi ko na po a while ago, those are the things that we need to consider in creating the analysis phase or in planning phase. We need to identify the problem, we need to identify who are the learners, we need to have a clear learning goals, and of course, the time frame kung kailan po natin ibibigay ang ating instruction sa ating mag-aaral para ma-achieve niya yung hinihingi nating learning or para ma-achieve natin yung objectives na ninanais natin doon sa learning process or instructional design na ginagawa natin.
Other questions?
Salamat po ba, sir? Salamat po sa inyong mga magagandang katanungan. Sana po, last na yan. May question pa po? So we can proceed now. Sir, okay. Pero okay po tayo. Nasagot ko po ba ang tanong? Maraming salamat po sa tanong.
Okay.
Mukhang wala na. Thank you so much po sa mga, sabi nga kanina ni ng ating first speaker, thank you for that wonderful question. No? Okay, let's now proceed to the second part of our discussion, which is the learning packet. So ito yung nilalaman or content ng ating learning packets na ibibigay or ibabahagi sa ating mag-aaral. If I'm not mistaken, like what Sir Chad said last meeting, na ito ay funded by our school MOOE. So ang ating school ang magpo-produce ng ating learning packets that will be distributed to our learners. At hindi ko lang alam kung paano yung proseso, no? Kung paano siya i-distribute sa ating mag-aaral. And with that, ang makakasagot po niyan ay ang ating administration. But I am here to discuss what are the different parts of these learning packets. Okay, we have the guide or parents guide, guide to the facilitators, learners guide, worksheets, enhancement activity or enrichment activities, of course, the instructional design, and this is also called as learning plan. Alam kong ginagawa niyo yan, kaya lahat tayo ay nakakagawa ng instructional design. Ang nangyayari lang, hindi natin siya siguro nagagawa systematically, no? Para ma-achieve natin successfully or effectively ang isang instruction na ginagawa natin. And then, the weekly home learning task, and of course, the individual monitoring tool. Okay, let's start with the parents guide. Simula tayo sa parents guide. Si Technical, Ma'am Maricel, okay lang po ba kung pwedeng pakibasa tong halimbawang parents guide na nasa slide?
Para nag-out po ata si Ma'am Maricel.
Ako na lang po, Mr. Moderator, kung pwede.
Teka lang. Kinakailangan ko na salamin.
Alis po na ako sa webcam.
Okay. So, dear parents, education can and must continue, but under the conditions and health protocols by DOH and WHO. Yes, we can do it. DepEd Valenzuela is partnering with you, parents, guardians, to support distance learning while your children are at are home. As your child's first teacher, we empowered you to utilize the resources provided to foster deeper understanding of grade level mathematics. With your guidance, your child shall complete various learning activities through home-based learning using the learning packets to be provided by DepEd SDO Valenzuela. This parent's guide is provided to assist you on your significant role on your child's learning process progress. Schedule your child an hour per day from Monday to Friday to study using this learning packet. As the materials demonstrate, samples activities with a lot of follow-up exercises, feel free to engage your child in this work. Always monitor what your child is doing and see to it that intended weekly learning packets is completed. Ask your child to show the solutions and explain the answer in your presence. When needed, you have your child add model or drawing to help them solve and record answer in complete sentences. The learning packet contains weekly lessons with follow-up activities and exercises. Self-learning reflection is also included next to the exercises to give the students a chance to explain what have learned and see to it that all worksheets will be completed by your child.
Thank you so much, Sir Moderator, for reading the example of parents' guide. So kung nabasa po natin or narinig natin kay Mr. Moderator, ang nilalaman niya is kung anong situation meron tayo nowadays and how the Department of Education will team up or tie up with our parents or facilitator at home for them to guide our learners or students para maging successful ang learning experience ng ating mag-aaral, no? So, sa paggawa niya ng ating parents guide and other guides that we have, it will depends on your creativity kung paano nyo mabibigay or maisusulat siya ng mas kaaya-aya at mas nakakahikayat, no, sa part ng mga parents or facilitator na meron sa bahay. So especially ang mga English and Filipino teacher, napakagaling dyan in terms of constructing that kind of letters, no, para mas maging kahali-halina, no, at kaaya-aya sa pagbabasa, no, or pandinig din ng ating mga facilitator or the parents. So sinasabi kong facilitator kasi hindi lang naman tayo as teacher or their facilitator, no? Kasi nga sa bahay wala tayo, sa bahay nila, no? So kung sino man yung nakakatanda or magulang na nandoon na pwedeng mag-guide sa kanila, that can be one, no? Facilitator. The second part is the, sabi ko na kanina, facilitators or guide to the facilitator. Anun din, no? Giving a reminder or instruction doon sa facilitator, pwede nga itong maging parents or pwede rin itong maging nakakatanda or kung sino man yung guardian na humahalili doon sa mag-aaral, no, that he or she need to follow kung ano yung dapat na ma-achieve na objectives ng ating mag-aaral. So yan yun. So yan yung example. So siguro hindi ko naman babasahin, no. So yung possible na maging content lang niya. Again, depende po sa inyo kung paano niyo gagawing mas maganda. So be more creative in constructing this kind of guide to our facilitator or the parent. So it's up to us kung paano natin ma-deliver ng maayos at maganda ang ganitong klaseng letter or guide. And then we have the...
Sir, may question tayo.
Ano po yung tanong?
From Sir Peralta of Senior High School.
Yes, Sir Peralta!
The social action of the Catholic Church has this paradigm. See, judge, act in analysis process. What paradigm do you suggest that will integrate the guiding principles you mentioned? Certainly. Thanks po.
Ano yung mga guiding principles na minention niya, sir?
See, judge, act.
Okay. So, di ba nga sabi nga dun sa mga naunang talk, di ba? Yung tinatawag nating integrity, honesty, no? Yung honesty and integrity na sinasabi, no? It will depend upon the students or the learners kung paano niya gagawin yung ating learning instruction na binigay sa ating mag-aaral.
Okay. Another question. Pwede kaya yan in Tagalog? From Opo. Sir Joselito.
Ito po.
Para matiging maintindihan ng magulang.
Opo.
Ay, sabi daw po, Filipino pala.
Okay, kasi it depends upon the subject matter that we are teaching or the tinatawag nating medium of instruction. Okay? So, in different subjects, we do have medium of instruction. For example, in MAPE. So ang aming medium of instruction is English, so that we need to apply the English one. But for Filipino, ESP, Araling Panlipunan, they can use this translation for yung Filipino or Tagalog. So, depende po sa asignatura, depende sa key stage ng bata. Kung halimbawa, mother tongue, so mother tongue ang gagamitin. Depende po sa key stage and medium of instruction kung anong language ang ilalagay natin.
Okay po, continue na po.
Okay po, thank you po. So, ito nga po pala ulit yung Tagalog version, no, nung Guide to the Facilitator or tinatawag natin sa Tagalog or Filipino na gabay sa tagapagdaloy. No, yan po yung Tagalog version nung nauna kanina. Okay, so pwede po siyang Tagalog. So, again, depende sa medium of instruction and the key stage level of the learner. Okay, next! Sa mag-aaral naman po, so parang kanina lang din, a reminder, instruction to our learners kung ano yung dapat niyang gawin doon sa ibibigay sa kanyang learning materials to achieve a specific goal. Nakalagay din dyan na kailangan sundin kung ano yung schedule na binigay ng paaralan sa kanya. Hindi porket nasa bahay na, eh meron ng sariling oras. So, meron pa rin sinusunod na time frame tayong tinatawag. Okay, so yun po yung ating guide for the learners. So may Tagalog version din po siya. Gabay sa mag-aaral. So ganun din po nakalagay. So nakalagay din dito na pwedeng kontakin din ang ating teacher through Messenger. So pwedeng naka-include din po doon sa ating gabay sa mag-aaral or guide to our learners. So yan po yung content niya. Okay? And worksheet. So marami na po ba sa atin ang gumagawa ng worksheet sa ating subject area? So ito po halimbawa ang binigay ko, no? Ito ay sa arts. So isa sa ginawa ko during the crafting of module in arts 9. So sa taas, sa upper part, naka-indicate po dito yung pangalan. Then grade and section at yung petsa or date. Then the title of the activity. And what are the learning competency or the learning competency code? So dapat nakalagay po yun dun para clear kung ano yung objectives or MELT na inatin na target sa particular worksheet or activity. And also naka-indicate din dyan kung anong quarter at kung anong araw or kung anong week din. Depende sa subject matter. And then meron din po tayong reminder or guide for the learners. And so with the guide for the parents. And then after that, a brief discussion or tawag dito, an instruction or direction to the student on the things he or she were going to do to answer that particular worksheet. So yan po yung halimbawa ng format ng ating worksheet na binigay ng division office, no, as we go along on the webinar ni Sir Moscosa. Okay. The other one, aside from worksheet, we have the enhancement activity or enrichment activity na tinatawag natin. Mas kilala siya sa enrichment activity. So, enrichment activity para mas lalong ma-master ng ating mag-aaral, no, kung ano yung gusto nating ma-achieve na learning objectives during the instructional process or period. Okay, so halimbawa nito, ito, giving instruction, then the activity na sasagutan niya. Okay, so yan yung enhancement activity. So sa arts pa rin yan. And then we have the instructional design. So also known as work plan. Tinatawag din po natin siyang work plan. So ano yung mga parts ng instructional design or work plan na ibinigay sa atin or binato sa atin ng division office? We have the subject area. We have the grade level. Quarter, week, then guide to the parents, guide to the learners, content standard, and the performance standard. Okay, yan po yung first part na naka-include sa ating instructional design. And then on the second part po, meron tayong table dito na kung saan ang first column is about day, lesson number, and the topic. And the second column is the MELTs or objectives that we need to achieve on that particular module or learning materials. And then the materials or things be needed on the instruction process or also the references like textbooks, no, na naka-include dito to be included in learning packets. And of course, the different activities and assessments. So nakalagay din dyan. So particular objectives or MELT, meron tayong particular activities and assessment na binibigay. But on our part in MAPE department, kasi broad yung topic, like for example, a specific art form which is paintings na kung saan nagbavary sa different era. So that's why nagkaroon ng learning objectives and the activities and assessment are as one, as a whole, to achieve those particular learning objective. So mamaya papakita ko po iyon. And then notes to the facilitator. So mabibigay tayo ng halimbawa dyan mamaya. Okay, ito naman yung Tagalog version. No, asignatura, tinuturo ang grado o baitang, markahan, linggo, gabay sa magulang o tagapagdaloy, gabay sa mag-aaral, pamantayang nilalaman, at pamantayan sa pagganap. Ang lalim, no? And then, yung sa table naman, Tagalog, araw, aralin, bilang, paksa. Layunin, Kagamitang nakalagay sa learning packet, mga gawain, pagtataya, at paalala sa tagapagturo sa bahay or sa tagapagdaloy. Okay, ito po yung halimbawa sa akin na ginawa ko. So for subject area, I have the arts. Dito po kasi ako natoka or na-assign ng aming EPS sa MAPE. And then grade level is grade 9 and a quarter is first quarter, and this is good for week 1 to 2. And then guide to the parents, ito yung halimbawang ginawa ko dito. So sabi ko nga sa inyo, it depends upon you kung ano yung nasa learning materials or modules nyo. So parang nakikipag-usap lang ako dito talaga sa magulang. Hello parents, our learners need your guidance on practical works, especially being cautious on what they are doing, and guide them in following the direction and answering the questions in each part of the activities and the exercises, and help them to focus on the lesson and monitor them if needed. So simple lang, ganun lang kasimple. And then for my guide to the learner, may I remind you that this plan is developed to guide you in your learning journey by following the steps in every activities and exercises, and answer all the assessment given here. Don't worry, because Kuya Art and his twin sister Clara will help you with this journey. Please be guided with your class schedule even if we are at home. If you notice, meron tayong sinamang character, which is Kuya Art and Sister Clara. Kasi on the learning materials or modules that we have here na ginawa ko, merong character akong ginawa dun sa instructional material na kung saan magsisilbing parang ako, na kung saan igaguide sila on their every chapter or on every journey on the flow of the learning instruction. Okay? And then content standard po, alam ko naman na meron tayong lahat niyan sa ating bawat MELCs or CG, and so with the performance standards. And ito na yung second part, day less number and topic for my day, week 1 and 2, kasi sa amin ay per week ang components. Kasi in every week, apat na components po kami. We have the music, arts, PE, and health. Those are good for week 1. Hindi siya magiging day 1, 2, 3, 4 of that particular week. Kaya po nakalagay dyan ay week 1 to 2 instead of day 1 or 2. And then lesson number, this is lesson number 1. And then the topic is Western Classical Art, which is painting. Kasi broad to, kasi tatlo yung art form na meron tayo rito. We have the painting, the sculpture, and so with the architecture. So ang ginawa namin for us to trim down the broad topic, we divided it into three art forms. So instead na pag-rambulin siya as a whole, na magkakahalo yung tatlong art form. Kasi ang haba ng period. So we have different period here. We have ancient period, classical period, and medieval period. And under those period, may mga subtopics pa or sub-eras na meron. So kaya magiging mahaba kung pagsasamahin sa whole. And ito yung MELCs or learning objectives na meron po doon sa ginawa na na particular instructional design, which is analyze art elements and principles in the production of work following the styles of Western and classical art, and so on. Okay? Ito naman yung materials. So, ang ginamit na materials dito, ito yung pre-naft namin or na-craft na instructional material or module ng ating division, which is quarter 1, module 1, Western Classical Arts Painting. Okay? And don't forget to write a particular page number on that particular learning materials, especially sa activities. So, kahilera niya dapat yung pages para hindi maliligaw ang ating learners and facilitator kapag ito ay nasa mag-aaral na. Like for example here, ang kailangan materials on page 1 to 2 are pen and paper for the pre-assessment, which is what I know. Part 1 is I belong and part 2 is follow up. Yung iba sa ibang subject area, talagang nilalagay nila yung buong activity nakalagay doon, no? So sa amin, para makatipid sa papel, we just give the page number and so with the title of the particular exercises or assessment. Okay? So again, sa ibang subject matter naman, ang ginagawa, like for example, sa science, may particular objective. Okay? Sa particular objective or milk na yon, may particular activities na nakarender to gain or to achieve that particular objectives. And so with the assessment. Okay? Kasi dito sa arts kasi, if you notice, pito yung learning competencies niya. But still mixed yung activities and assessment. Kasi in every activities and assessment, yung mga learning competencies dyan ay natatouch or nasasapul din nung ibang activities na meron tayo rito. Okay? And then for the notes to the facilitator, ito halimbawa, nilagay natin, guide the learners on practical works, especially being cautious on what they are doing and guide them in following the directions and answering the questions each part of the activities and exercises. And lastly, be mindful on the specific time given on each activities and assessment. So para mag-guide din natin yung ating tagapagdaloy or yung magulang habang nagsasagot or ginagawa ng ating mag-aaral yung learning instruction na binigay sa kanila. Okay? So yun po yung ating instructional design. So may tanong po ba tayo dito? Para po mamaya sa activity, magkakaroon po tayo ng groupings. You will going to create your own instructional design by group. Okay, wala po tayong tanong sa instructional design.
Sir, yes po? Malabo daw po yung PowerPoint, ang sabi ni Sir Charval Gavica.
Malabo?
Apo?
O, dyan po yan.
May pwede ba tayong mag-provide ng samples sa ano sa group or something like?
Pwede naman i-screenshot ko tapos i-send ko doon sa GC ng association.
Okay.
Okay, ganun na lang po gawin natin, no? Screenshot ko siya and then I will going to send it on the group of the association of our faculty. Okay, meron pa po. Para klaro tayo dito kasi gagawin natin mamaya.
Yung tanong kanina na na-beaten kay Sir Jacinto,
ano
sabi niya, yung kanina, di ba, ang tanong niya is kung pwede kaya daw Tagalog, Filipino, para madaling maintindihan. Follow-up question is, but how about yung mga magulang mismo na hirap sa English?
Okay, sa akin pong sagot ha, kasi ito po ay binigay na instruction, no? Ng ating division office. And I don't know kung ano yung pwedeng gawin. Pwedeng maging school-based yan. Halimbawa, ang gawin ni school head natin or ng administration natin, may English and there is a translation sa ibaba. No, will it depends on the local arrangement. Pero kasi ang binato ng central and so with the division office is it depends upon the key stage level and so with the medium of instruction per subject matter.
Okay.
Okay ba?
Do we have questions? Baka may mag-feed dito.
Sana wala na para makapag-activity na tayo.
Okay. It says na parang wala na po.
Okay, konti na lang. Okay. The other one is weekly home learning task. So sa weekly home learning task po natin, ito yung sample niya, ito yung content niya. We have the learning area. Example ko dito is science. Kasi po ang nag-discuss po sa amin nito is si Ma'am Prondo, ang EPS ng science. Siya po ang nag-discuss sa amin. Yan, napaka-informative at ang dami po naming natutunan during the discussion. So grade level, grade 9, quarter 1, week is 1, and inclusive date is August 24 to 28, 2020. And ito yung nakalagay sa table. Day and time. So, day 1, ang time ay 7 a.m. to 8 a.m. Okay, baka may magtanong, saan po makukuha yung oras? Okay, it depends upon the schedule given by our school. Okay, kasi ang alam ko, nag-aantay pa sila ng schedule coming from the central dahil dun sa channel, no? Ng instruction na ibibigay. And so, with the local city government na kung saan yung FB Live, if I'm not mistaken, magkakaroon daw ng FB Live ang ating city sa pagbibigay ng instruction. So, again, magbabarian depende sa ibibigay sa ating schedule. And then a particular learning competency, example dito sa science. Explain how the respiratory and circulatory system work together to transport nutrients, gases, and other molecules to and from the different parts of the body. So yun yung particular learning competency na meron tayo dito. And then ang mga learning tasks on that particular competency is identify the key parts of the breathing system, describe the function of each part of the breathing system, and explain how the lungs work. So ito, i-rate nila, no? Yung level of understanding nila doon sa particular learning task and so with the objectives. Halimbawa, pag 4 ang sinagot nila, sabi dyan, I definitely can do this and I can also teach others. So, kaya niya at pwede pa siyang makapagturo sa iba. Yun yung level of understanding. Ang 3 naman, ang level of understanding, I am confident that I can do this on my own. Kaya niyang answeran or maintindihan yung particular topic or task, but he or she can share it with others or teach it to others. And then the second or two, level 2 is I think I can do this on my own, but I am not sure. So he or she is uncertain. And number 1 for level 1, I really don't get this and I need help. Yun po yung para sa ating weekly home learning task. So parang kumbaga ina-assess ni learner yung capability or level of understanding niya to a particular learning task and so with the learning competencies. Okay, that is for the weekly home learning task. And last but not the least, we have the individual monitoring tool. Ito naman po ay para sa ating mga teachers. Okay? So, individual monitoring plan, nakalagay dyan yung learner's name or pangalan ng mag-aaral, subject area or asignaturang tinuturuan or asignatura ng bata, and then grade level, and so with this table. Nakalagay yung learner's need. Ano yung pangangailangan ng mga ng bata? Ano yung mga pangangailangan niya on that particular subject or subject area? And then intervention strategies. So ano yung mga intervention strategies na pwede mong magawa for the learners to develop or makakope up on that particular needs. And then monitoring date, kailan mo to ginawa or kailan mo siya minonitor. And then learner status, ano yung naging progress nung tinandak mo yung intervention strategies and the monitoring process on that particular learning needs. Is it insignificant progress? Wala bang naging resultang maganda? Significant progress, nagkaroon naman ng development, and of course, mastery. No, nakuha na kagad ng bata yung particular learner's need, no, na-achieve niya. And then, the intervention status or remarks na pwede nating ilagay. So, yan po yung parts or content ng ating individual monitoring plan.